Heads.
You're going to call it in the air?
Go on then. Heads. Is it heads? Alright, well, as soon as I won that, you get first choice of swim. I bet we get there and he's disappeared already, hasn't he?
I think that was the main, he looked a bit worried.
Yeah, he did look. He looked up for it. There's two. There's a common as well, no?
It's one cast.
Ooh. Right, mate.
They're hempers, the dog's nuts, man. I'll be with you 1 second, lads.
Yeah, you're all right. Fair enough.
Well, yeah.
Anyway, I'm Chris. Nice to meet you.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you, mate.
Cheers, mate. Right, so welcome to another vlog. We're back on the bank. But this time we're on linear. We were going to go farlows, but after the Facebook update of how quiet it was, we thought it was an opportunity that we would miss otherwise. So yeah, we popped up here, we had a little look around, and where have we dropped in, mate?
Yeah, so we've dropped in on OXLEASE, and it's not too busy, so yeah, we found a few swims, a few fish have been showing. We did have a little nose around St. John's, and to be fair, we saw a couple of fish in the edge that were worth having a go for. I won the coin toss, so I had a little go, but fluffed it up. What can you do? But yeah, we've settled on OXLEASE. It's been a few fish showing. They've obviously stopped since we've got here, which is standard. Yeah. But I think it's going to be a bit zig fishing for the time being, and maybe get a bit of bait out for the evening, innit? So
go from there, really, innit? Yeah.
But hopefully we can get a few. See what happens.
Come back to you later on with the same carp. Yeah.
Let's get the rods out and
get on with it.
Hopefully we'll catch something. Right, we've been in a swim for about 10 minutes, just done a bit of an intro, and there's been a few fish showing in close, and basically there's been a load of water just sort of churning up down here, real coloured up. Definitely a few fish come in close and had a little look about in the silt, I reckon, just in front of me. There's been a couple of fish rolling sort of a bit further out. So I've literally just dropped in a solid bag just with one rod for a bit. I've just lowered it in just down here. And we'll just see if that goes off, because there's definitely a few fish in close. You can see just there. No way you can pick that out, but it's fizzing up just down there. So yeah, there's definitely a few fish in here, so you never know, we might be able to nick a quick bite. There's been a few tench nodding around, so it could be tench. So yeah, there's been a few tench nodding around down there as well, so you never know, it could be tench. But there's been a few carp roll, and it's literally the surface of the water swirling, where there's obviously fish down there churning the bottom up. It's now colouring up again, right over the top of my solid bag. So if that don't go, I'd be amazed. Looks absolutely perfect for it at the moment. Oh wow, it is absolutely churning down there.
Right then, so little update, it's now kind of getting on for late afternoon. It's been absolutely red hot today, probably 24-25 degrees. I think we're both going to be sunburnt. There's plenty of fish cruising around, but they look very lethargic and they don't really look up for anything at the moment, to be honest. We've had zigs out all day, and yeah, nothing's produced so far, but I'm going to just start knocking up my sort of evening mix, probably fish a couple on the deck and then one on the zigs, just so we've got both aspects covered. So I thought as I'm doing it, I'd just run you through what I'm sticking in it. So to start off with, I've got some, this is crumbed up, the new DNA bug, which will be coming out soon. So yeah, crumbed it up with a load of pellet as well, and then that's been soaking in the matching glug. So that's probably about a kilo in there. And then exactly the same with the S7, which, as you probably know if you watch the channel, absolutely love. So yeah, exactly the same, crushed up in the Ridge Monkey crusher. And there's a bit of crushed up pellet in there as well. So it's probably a give or take, probably a kilo and a half or so in there. So that's all crumbed up. I'm going to keep them grubbing around for ages. Anyone that knows Linear or Oxford in general really knows they absolutely love the corn, so we silly not to put some of that in it. This was frozen, we bought it this morning because it was a, as you know, a last minute change from Farlow's to Oxford, so yeah. Take a while to get out, boys. It's frozen this morning. Probably 3/4 of a bag of that in there. I might start eating that myself in a minute because it's still slightly frozen, so it's about the only cool thing we've got left now. And yeah. Along with that would be some hemp. Should have prepared the lid really earlier. Bear with me, get there in a minute. There we go. Unfortunately I split the bottom on the... It fell off the barrel earlier, so I split the bottom, see. About half a jar of that. Got some, this is some of the 12mm S7, so they'll be going in whole. Just probably a scoop and a half of them. They've been glugging for months now, they had a shelf life, been glugging for months in the matching hydro syrup. And then gonna stick some, so this is the DNA krill meal. It's just absolutely potent, so I'm going to stick a good whack of that in there, just bind some of it together. And also, while I'm going to be spotting it out, I've still got two zigs out, which I'll be spotting over the top of, so that'll create a bit of a cloud in the water, bring in a bit of attraction, and yeah, hopefully keep them going. Yeah, and then last but not least, this is some of the 8mm. Yeah, 8mm SLK they are, so size of a pellet, absolutely tiny. Once again, it's just going to keep the fish grubbing around for ages. So. There we go, not too many of them. So that is going to be the mix. Give it a good mix around, I'll give you a close up in a minute. So long and short of it, it's lots of little pieces just to keep the fish grubbing around once we get them in the air. Keep them feeding, and obviously then they'll come across the hook bait, and hopefully that'll be one in the bag, two in the bag, and by the end of the night I'll have at least 10. But that's the idea at least. I don't think we'll give them too much bait because I don't think they're fully on it because of the weather. But yeah, that's going to be the mix, and I'll give you a little close up now.
Right, so you've seen the Hughes mix, and there's mine. Quite similar, same items really, same boilies, corn, that sort of stuff. The only difference is I've switched up the hemp and put in the cray mix, little mini pellets, and I'm using quite a bit more sweet corn. But other than that, I've still got the boilies, the crumb, and all the other stuff in there. So, yeah, very similar, but slightly different. So, yeah, we'll see if it works, and hopefully the fish love it too.
And then move the other way.
Yeah. Reel it in or?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, reel it in. Yeah, it's in the weed.
That's fine. The fish is this side.
Yeah, I know. No,
and you just get out there with that now.
Yeah, I know. And get out of the weed.
Oh, it's a trainer. It's a trainer. No, it won't. It's coming back.
I'm going to grab it a breeze.
Huh?
I'm going to grab it a breeze.
I'm going to ask you, mate. It's going to fucking... You need to get a fish.
Right, so just thought I'd bite number one, guessing away, but turned out to be a trailer. Just wiped out all three rods, but the good news is, with a bit of nifty work between the two of us, we managed to get it in and recover the pretty terrible rig. So, good news is, sending the fish back nice and healthy, put a bit of carp care on its lips, and taking as much opportunity, just gonna let him recover for a minute and then we'll slip him back, so. Probably a mid-20, so lovely looking fish. Thought I had my first OXLEASE fish, but turns out it wasn't to be, but... There we go. Might not be in a bite, but at the end of the day, at least we're returning the fish nice and healthy now, so we can carry on. Live another day.
Oh, you, oh, you idiot.
That's me. Good mate.
Sometimes it's the simple things in life.
Right then, so bit of an evening update for you. Lights going. We've just smashed our barbecue, which was awesome. We had what was it? Minted
lamb koftas.
Oh, they were good, and with some smoky bacon sauce as well. So yeah, that was pretty nice.
As you can tell, nothing's happened because we're talking about food.
Yeah. Standard.
No. Yeah. But other than that, fish wiping me out. That was as much action as we had.
Yeah.
And yeah, we're all reset for the night now, but. The fish do appear to have moved off potentially. Yeah. They're not cruising around like they have been all day, but then again, like you say, it's coming into the latter hours of light now. Fingers crossed they'll be dropping down, isn't it, you know? And
let's hope so, yeah. I mean, the weather is not bad. It's quite mild, overcast, so hopefully they might switch on and in the cover of darkness and we'll have a busy night. So hopefully, shortly, we'll be showing you a few fish, but if not, I suppose we'll have a catch up in the morning. So
yeah. Cue the rods rattling off.
Yeah.
No.
Right. Nah, that didn't work. Oh well. We'll see in a bit.
Take the ball.
What are they doing?
Leave it alone. Stop casting out.
Nothing to update from the night, as you've probably worked out yourselves. Yeah, I didn't have even a liner, to be honest. I think Sean had a couple of bleeps, but very cute all in all. Loads of people have turned up this morning. The lake is pretty much full now, as per normal, and yeah, there's still a few fish showing, but on the whole they're kind of showing on the far side of the lake to us, to be honest. So saying that, we've just seen a couple real in close, just the other side of a bit of a weed bed in front of us. So I think we're going to have a bit of change tactic. Hope while everyone else is setting up, sending leads out to the middle, It might push the fish into that those sort of little pockets of water with no lines and no pressure. So yeah, we're going to flick out for me a couple of Ronnies, put a little bit of bait just over the top and see if that can yeah, create something for the last few hours of the session. So yeah, let's get these out.
Right then, little change of tactics this morning. We've seen the fish closer in, so I flicked two just the other side of a weed bed. Yeah, and this one's gone rattling off. Absolutely chuffed to get a bite, I won't lie. From the lads walking around this morning, it doesn't seem like the lake's potentially done a fish this morning from what we've heard. So yeah, to nab a bite, and I expect that's exactly what it is, an opportunist fish just swimming past. Absolutely chuffed. Yeah, happy days, isn't it? This one's yeah, it was a little orange Fruitalicious pop-up on the old faithful Ronnie. Like I say, just on the other side of a close-in weed bed. Get in there.
Right, morning update for you then. Use that one.
Woohoo!
Nice fish. Acted on a bit of just, well, saw a couple of fish, didn't you, really?
Yeah, instincts, really.
Yeah.
Seen a couple of fish closer in. There's a nice weed bed in front of us, so we thought, well, let's fish off the back of it and see if it can produce, and lo and behold, we managed to nab an opportunist fish, I think, so.
Yeah, so, I mean, it's definitely scratching for bites at the moment up here. It's been really hot weather. Yesterday was awful. Like, you know, we were drained by the evening. So, I think tactics-wise, I think sometimes like just bags, you know, a little bit of bait here and there, nothing too crazy. And also the zigs, we've been working at zigs, but I'm surprised they haven't come good really, the zigs. But
well, yeah, I think the lads up from us had a couple of fish yesterday early morning, and then before that sort of weather really kicked in, and since then it's just been sort of dead across the lake by the sounds of it. So yeah, it's not been the one, but it's nice to be out on the bank, isn't it? And
yeah, definitely. I mean, I think we're going to give it till sort of later on this afternoon. So hopefully we've got another chance of a bite. But yeah, we'll try our best and see if we can produce another one, innit?
Yeah.
See how we get on. Right, and that's the end of the session. Unfortunately, I didn't have anything, and as you can probably see on the van, Hugh's decided to write his bragging rights on there because he managed one.
Yeah, hopefully he'll be following me all the way back to Bristol, and I'll be rubbing it in.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I hear about that until we next get out. But to be fair, you know, he don't go out as much as me, so it's nice to see him put one on the bank. The weather's not been the best, but it's been quite nice to sit out, have a few beers and have a barbecue last night, so yeah. It wasn't too bad.
I think it's got a few socials going on around the lake.
Yeah.
You might be able to hear in the background, but yeah. It's been red hot. It's sapped a lot of our energy, to be honest, but hopefully it comes across in the blog and you get enough out of it.
Yeah.
And yeah, if you enjoyed it, hit like, comment below, give us some tips if you'd like something else in them, and yeah, make sure you hit that subscribe button.
Yeah, so until next time, thanks for watching. And gather and be lucky. We'll see you all soon.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Come on.
Yeah.